All right, it's time to talk about the new Easter mystery box that came out about a week ago. The box was 85 Robux and promised one gun, which it delivered, giving us the blunderbuss. For the people that are unaware of what a blunderbuss is, basically think of a 1700s shotgun. But to start off with the positives about this gun, I'll talk about the model. The model for this gun is absolutely amazing. Just like all the other 1700 guns, the details on this gun are just great. One of the versions of the gun actually has a plaque on it with a name on it that you can incorporate into your character's lore, or the lore of that gun itself. I also like the added details of the more realistic firing of this kind of weapon, where there's also smoke and sparks coming out of the back end of the gun where the percussion cap is located. Another good thing about this gun is it basically acts like a cheaper version of the 8 gauge for people that weren't able to get it from the Christmas mystery box. Being only a bit slower to reload and one less shot, it's still a great choice for some people that want serious firepower. But with all the good out of the way, let's talk about the bad here. And there's a lot more of it, is the fact that this is a limited time item that costed 85 Robux. Now, of course, some people may ask why that matters, since it's so cheap and something of that power should be limited. But the main reason that that price point is such an issue is the fact that all the other year-round packs in the item shop or on the Roblox page are around that 85 Robux price point, and they can give you so much more that is so much more useful. Either you only have to spend a few Robux more to get more items, or a few Robux less to also get more items. But there is one pack I want to highlight, in part because it has the exact same price, the Coalition pack. In this pack, you get a rifle, pistol, shovel, and food. This isn't even mentioning the fact that the rifle can be converted into an LMG, and the pistol can be converted into a full auto carbine. And this is all stuff you could purchase year-round. And in this limited time box, we get a single gun that is extremely slow loading and has a very high caliber. The problem with that is super high caliber shotguns like this one and the 8 gauge have incredibly niche roles and have no real practical combat uses. This other fellow After the Flash creator, known as After the Flash Exotic Weapons, has a decent video about this explaining how kind of pointless these guns are. And the only main reasons you have them are for big game hunting such as Eldridge and breaching doors and walls. And with its super slow loading, it's gonna be worse at both of those things compared to the 8 gauge. So it just confuses me why they would ever wanna put a limited time mystery box item, especially Easter. Putting a gun like this in an Easter box makes no sense. I do understand that the reason it's done that way is to reflect the in-game lore rarity of that gun. Hence why all the really overpowered good stuff is in the more expensive boxes like the Super Mystery Box. But I really do feel both the Blunderbuss and 8 gauge should have been put in a Wild West pack with lower calibers or something like that. This feels like a gun that somebody should knowingly make the choice to have and not it unexpectedly come out of left field from a mystery box and you're now stuck with it. This is because it's in a mystery box that you would least expect it to come out of. At the very least, this is definitely a gun that should have been saved for next Thanksgiving. Because if someone bought the Thanksgiving box and was actually surprised that they got a weapon from the 1700s or older, I have no words for you, because you're already just a lost cause. To wrap this up, another minor complaint here, because this one is more of a personal one. I don't like how it's a well-kept and quality-made firearm. I highly enjoy all these scrap-built weapons, and it could have been really cool seeing something like a reimagined Countryman, which was a scrap blunderbuss. But that's just me at the end. Alrighty, that's the end of the video. I hope you guys did enjoy. Let me know in the comments if you agree with this, or if you don't. I know this is definitely not a video that's gonna get what was inside the mystery box changed, but I just wanted to share my feelings while showcasing the new items. And mostly because one of my friends has been bugging me to make this video because of how upset they were. And yeah, I'll see y'all around.